Thank you for wanting to know more about the Bear Facts. The Bear Facts Band of LaPorte, Indiana, a band that played throughout the Midwest, throughout the Chicago area, with members whose ages ranged from 15 and 16, a mutual love of Motown, the British Invasion, and of course horn bands, brought these young men together in 1965. In 1966, Dan Topolsky started what would become the Bear Facts, along with Dave Curtis, Ron Shaw, Jim Sight, Bob Neblung, and Wes England. The Bear Facts were unusual, writing their own material and performing their own songs. The band had a road manager and security that accompanied them. They opened for many local legends, groups like the Crying Shames, the New Colony Six, the American Breed, and the Buckinghams. In 1968, the Bear Facts recorded two of their most significant songs at Universal Studios in Chicago, releasing those two songs in the Chicago market, where their songs were extremely popular among listeners. The Bear Facts were honored by being asked to play at Orchestra Hall in Chicago, along with Tommy James and the Shondells in 1968. The Bear Facts performed with many big opening acts, including James Brown, the Turtles. Along with their performances, they also were honored to play for Robert Kennedy during a whistle stop tour in LaPorte, Indiana. On his way to Los Angeles, he was killed some 2 weeks later. The Bear Facts continued to perform for enthusiastic audiences between 1965 and 1971. Music began to change. Horn bands, like many other of the original bands of their time, became passé, and the Bear Facts called it quits. Many of the members moving on to college and marriages, some continuing on with the band for another year, adding members like Harold Staples on lead guitar, Frank Van Schoik on bass, but eventually called it quits for good. In 2013, the band reunited after 50 years and is still performing today. Thank you so much for wanting to know more about the Bear Facts. Again, thank you so much for your interest in the Bear Facts.